I'm Lowcode, and today I want to show you this pretty cool app that is a matching app between veterans and resources. The uniqueness about this app is that veterans fill a very long profile, and then based on that, they get matched with certain resources. So as you can see here, users will complete their profile. I'll click Next just to show you the onboarding process. And then they select the branch of service, the type of rank, or the Coast Guard, the start date, when they ended the service, or status, the type of discharge, then stuff about personal data, their license. They have to answer questions if they were injured during war, etc. And then they select any of the reasons that they want, and then they click submit. As soon as they've done that, they end up here in their profile, and you can see the profile progress. So this means that this user only completed certain part of the profile, so they didn't want to go through the whole thing. So they can always click the button to complete their profile, and then they'll be able to click and actually fill out all of these details, or they can just click and complete later. Now, the cool part about this app is that we're matching them with the appropriate resources. So in this case, based on this profile that this user completed, we're showing them, in this case, a couple of resources. There might be resources that are not showing for this user because, for example, let's say that this veteran was not injured, and there might be resources that only show up for injured veterans. So we always push for the veterans to complete the profile. Now, they can look at this resource, so shelter house, we have the about information, the applications, and the events. In this case, I'll check out Master Heroes, and in here, in applications, I will click on the first application, right? So I can see the details about this application. How can I apply for this resource? I can read the FAQs, and I can click the button Start Application. And then when I do, we move the user here over to the Applications tab, and then you can see the submitted and accepted applications. So in this case, I've submitted my application for Hyster Heroes, and this is the About section or the Qualifications section that I need to comply in order to be able to get this application. So now I'm going to show you the other side of the app, which is the resources dashboard. So now I've logged in as a resource admin, right? So I click on this resource, I complete my profile. Now this is a different profile for them, just overview description, and then I end up here in my profile. I can create new applications. So I would click the plus button and add a name, a description, the FAQs. I can add more FAQs if needed. And then when I click Next, I'll be able to select the fields that we need in order for the veteran to match to this application or resource. So we might have resources that are only available for males that were born between this year and that year, if they're married or not, if they've had children, where are they living, which branch of service or service status, their title of discharge. So I can create new applications. I go back to my applications, here I have my assigned applications, right? So we can see applications, and then, so that's how users get any applications. And then going back to our profile, we also have events, and then we can create new events. So pretty straightforward, title, image, date, location, link, and those events show up like this, right? Now, when a veteran applies for a resource that these resources companies or organizations are providing, then we end up here on the assigned and unassigned. So in this case, we have this application today, February 14, that has been submitted by a veteran. So when I click on this application, I can see when it was submitted, who submitted this application. So I can see these veterans' profile and all of their details, all of their public details, and then the questionnaire. So I can make sure that the veteran that is applying application or resource matches the resource, and then they can get the benefits out of it. So first thing that I'll do is I have to assign a caseworker. So now if we go to our casework tab, we can see the people that work for my organization, right? So I'm logged in as Hive for Heroes, and then Hive for Heroes has a couple of caseworkers that work for us. I can add a new caseworker, pretty straightforward. When I do that, they'll get an email, and when they log in, when the caseworker logs in, they will only be able to see the cases that they have been assigned. Right? So coming back to my application, I will assign Mark as a caseworker, and I click confirm, and that's it. So in this case, this application has been assigned to a caseworker. The veteran and the caseworker can check. And I can also go to the chat and see what they're doing. In this case, the caseworker is assigning tasks for the veteran. So so I can click on the tests tab, and me as an admin, I would be able to add a test as well. Make sure it's your ABC, add a description, and then the veteran will see these tests, and they will show a progress bar in terms of how many tasks they've completed, and they both can share images, videos, and files on this screen. Now I am logged in as Mark Hammer. Remember, Mark is a caseworker that works for a resource for an organization, right? So his app, his screen looks different. He has his own profile, he has the applications that he has been assigned to, and he has his chats. So if we look at the application number one, we can see the veteran who submitted this application, and then we can click here, go to chat, and then we'll be able to start chatting. In here, I can click post, and then I can assign tasks to this user. So another task, click submit. So we have multiple tasks here, and either me as a caseworker or the veteran himself, they'll be able to mark tasks as completed, and then we update the progress bar. And then since we want the veterans to share with us pictures, the veteran will be able to upload pictures and videos. In this case, the caseworker can only see those things. So the main functionality for the caseworker is here in the chat tab, where they are chatting between the veteran and themselves. Later on, it might be the case that the resource admin changes the caseworker to the right assignment, and that's something that the admin or the resource admin can do. Now, finally, we have the admin dashboard. In the admin dashboard, we have a list of users, and we can see every single user that has logged into our app, as well as the caseworkers. In both cases, I can click the plus button and either add a new veteran or add a new caseworker. We also have a list of every single resource that has logged into the app, and then we can see the profile, we can edit their profile, their about, we can see the applications and the events they have added. And we have the applications as well. So in order to keep track of who's doing what in the app, we can see every single submitted and accepted application that has gone through the app. So as the admin or the owner of the app, we can see pretty much everything. On the back end, we have connected Google Analytics so that the admin, the app owner, can see how many people are using the app, where they're coming from, how do they find the app, etc. So this is a pretty robust matching app with a very robust metric, or let's say algorithm, to create this matching. We've done a lot of these apps at Local Agency. We are Glide certified experts, we are Glide partners, as well as Integromat partners. So we have a lot of experience. We've built over 239 apps like this. So if you want an app, get in touch with us. We'll build an app for you in just 4 weeks. Thanks for watching. Bye.